Hello students, today we will continue our 11th chapter.
Automatic formatting of tables. Using auto format, you can apply a format from the predefined collection of table formats. You can also create your own table formats and save them as another auto format in the collection set. To apply an auto format, place the cursor anywhere in the table and choose Table Auto Format. An auto format dialog box will appear as shown in figure 11.11. Select the desired format from the list displayed on the left. You can see the actual look of the table as you move in the list and click OK to apply it. Deleting the table. To delete a table, you can click anywhere in the table and choose Delete Table from Table menu. Other way is similar to the one we use for deleting selected text. That is, start from the line above the table, drag the mouse till the line below the table to select the table and then simply press either delete key or backspace key. Copying a table. Copying a table is as simple as copying a selected text. That is, we select the table to be copied first by taking a cursor anywhere in the table and choose Table Select Table. Press Ctrl+C or select Copy option from the Edit menu or select the Copy icon from the standard toolbar or select Copy option after right click. Then take the cursor to the position where you want its copy and then select Paste. Either using menu or icon or by pressing Ctrl+V, moving a table is similar to copying a table except selecting cut instead of selecting copy. Other procedure is similar. Mail merge. Often you need to send the same information to several persons. For example, you want to send a letter to several candidates to be called for interview. Obviously, the address and interview time will be different for different candidates. At the same time, the other content will be same. One way is to create a letter in usual way. Copy this letter in a new document, change the address and interview time of a particular candidate and save the document with different name. The procedure of copying and changing is repeated as many times as the number of candidates. This way of creating multiple documents is very time consuming and tedious. Writer has made this task easy through the features called mail merge. In mail merge, two documents are created, one which is main document, also called the form letter, and the other is called the data source. The form letter contains the actual information and variable names for the data which varies in different letters. Data source contain values of the corresponding table of the main document. For example, mentioned above, the address of all the candidates with respective interview time would be stored in data source. Creating the data source. A data source is a set of mailing addresses in the form of a row or column, generally called database. Detailed study of database will be done in standard 10th. The content of the database in the form of data records, OOO, that is OpenOffice.org's writer supports the database in many forms. They are spreadsheet, text files and database such as MySQL, Adabase and ODBC. In the information to be used in the mail merge is currently in a format that OOO cannot access directly. You need to convert it to a comma separated values by exporting it. The extension of such files must be .csv. To create address book using spreadsheet or database is a little easier as they use a table format to store the data. We will make use of text files as other formats and yet to be studied. The text file is saved with the extension .txt. It is also possible to create address book during the mail merge process using mail merge wizard. Note that the comma separated file is also a text file, but the only difference is that the comma separated file will be converted into the table format after registering it with form letter or main document. Creating a text file for the data source. Any editor can be used to create a text file. We will use gedit text editor available with our operating system. To open the gedit text editor, click on application, accessories, gedit text editor. You can see here in your figure 11.12 how you have to open the gedit text editor. First click on application, in application click on accessories. In accessories you will get option for gedit text editor. Once you have opened the editor, type the content of first line. The first line generally should represent the title of each column, while typing the letter fields should be separated by a comma. Do not put comma at the end of the last title. Here you need to press enter key. The next line will contain the values corresponding to the titles entered by you. The values again should be separated by comma. We call this as the first record. There should always be one or more mapping between the number of titles and numbers of values. Similarly, additional record can be entered in the next line. Figure 11.13 shows sample data set. Save the file giving appropriate name and give .txt as extension. Note that the comma separated while is created exactly the same way. The only difference is in the extension of the file. The file in figure 11.13 is named address.txt. Once the text file is created, it should be registered first with the main document. The procedure for registering a data source is explained below.
Thank you for listening. In our next video, we will see registering a data source. Till then, take care.